Perusahaan kecantikan internasional Oriflame saat ini melakukan penjualan langsung di lebih dari 60 negara dan melibatkan lebih dari 3,6 juta konsultan independen. Penjualan tahunan perusahaan ini juga tidak main-main, 1,5 miliar euro atau sekitar 24 triliun rupiah. Apa yang membuat Oriflame bertahan dengan sistem penjualan langsung? Lalu apa rahasia di balik mengguritanya perusahaan ini? Kita akan temukan jawabannya lewat perbincangan dengan Magnus Brännström, CEO and President of Oriflame Holding, sekaligus menjabat sebagai Chairman of World Federation of Direct Selling Association.
Saat ini dunia mengalami transformasi digital, termasuk dalam sektor perdagangan. E-commerce semakin diminati. Jumlah pemain e-commerce terus bermunculan dan nilai transaksinya pun semakin meroket. Namun yang menarik, penjualan retail melalui metode direct selling atau penjualan langsung tidak kehilangan pangsa pasar. Transaksi penjualan langsung secara global pada 2016 tercatat sebesar 182,6 miliar dolar Amerika atau sekitar 2.446 triliun rupiah. Kontribusi terbesarnya datang dari kawasan Asia Pasifik yang menyumbang 46% penjualan global, Amerika Serikat 33%, Eropa 20%. Di Indonesia, penjualan langsung termasuk salah satu industri yang prospektif. Dalam 4 tahun terakhir, nilai transaksi tumbuh rata-rata sebesar 10%. Dan pada 2016 lalu mencapai 1,18 miliar dolar Amerika atau sekitar 15,75 triliun rupiah.
Dari tahun 2016 kita menunjukkan kenaikan 10%. Sedangkan kita dari tahun 2013 sampai tahun 2016 kita adalah kedua terbesar di dunia. Setelah Kazakhstan, ya, itu Kazakhstan nomor satu, kita yang nomor dua.
Artinya ke depan proyeksinya masih sangat baik ya Pak?
Proyeksinya masih sangat baik.
Lebih lanjut, Joko menilai masa depan penjualan langsung sangat cerah karena metode ini bisa dilakukan oleh siapa saja. Pasar Indonesia juga terus berkembang, didukung sumber daya manusia yang besar.
Mr. Magnus, thank you for having us. I would like to ask you several questions about direct selling since you are the chairman of World Federation of Direct Selling Association, right?
Yes.
Technology is always developing and in the era of boom e-commerce, you can buy almost everything from your smartphone, PC and tablet. You don't have to move everywhere, you don't have to meet anyone. Just push several buttons and the product you want will be delivered to you. Yeah. In this era, how do you see the prospect of direct selling?
Well, I think that you have to still decide what product to buy, because just because you can buy everything all the time from everyone doesn't mean you need everything from everyone all the time. You need something from someone. And how do you know what to buy? That's where direct selling comes on. So with your friends on social media, on your tablets, you will get recommendations for what products to buy. For example, what mascara would you like to buy, or what skincare to buy. And the ones that you trust the most are your friends. So therefore, direct selling will also play an important role tomorrow, because recommendation is actually, besides price, the strongest driver for what to buy on the internet.
Recommendation and social media.
Yes.
Is it like that?
Yes.
The future of direct selling.
That's direct selling of tomorrow.
Okay, but direct selling requires a physical meeting between at least two people, right?
No, why?
To deliver the product or the service.
Well, if you imagine the following, that I am a direct seller, you're a customer, we know each other, and I tell you about our great skincare. I sign you up. So maybe we know each other for the first time, but I will sign you up as a customer.
Okay.
And you buy from my site, but the products will be sent from, for example, Oriflame directly to you. So you and I are communicating on Facebook or Instagram or whatever social media platform we're using to communicate. But the physical deliveries will be directly from the company to you and to me.
So direct selling doesn't mean physical contact or physical meeting again. No,
not in the future.
Mm-hmm. That's the future of direct selling.
I think that's the future of direct selling.
Okay, so some people say that direct selling products are slightly more expensive than the non-direct selling products because you require physical meetings and some percentage of the price goes to the consultant. Is it true?
No, I don't necessarily think so. I think that actually most direct selling companies provide an even more affordable product. The thing is to compare what are the quality of the products. And if you compare in the old days, we have the wholesalers, we have the retailers, and instead of having wholesalers, retailers, and a large amount of advertising on TV, that money we are instead giving to the direct sellers. Mm-hmm. So actually, there is no difference in terms of that the direct selling product should be more expensive because of the direct selling method. It should more likely be cheaper. Mm-hmm. But let's speak at least that it's the same, then one should look at the quality of the product.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I would like to ask you more questions about direct selling in Indonesia.
All right.
But we have to take a break and we will continue this discussion. Pemirsa, jangan kemana-mana, perbincangan saya dengan Mr. Magnus Brandstrom akan dilanjutkan sesaat lagi. Anda kembali menyaksikan Top Eksekutif. Pemirsa, saya akan lanjutkan perbincangan dengan Magnus Brandstrom, CEO and President of Oriflame Holdings, sekaligus menjabat sebagai Chairman of World Federation of Direct Selling Association. Mr. Magnus, so compared to other countries, how does we Indonesian respond to direct selling? Is it good?
Very good, very good. I think that I have always found Indonesia to be very positive, very social. And that's to a large extent what direct selling is all about. So Indonesia has always been a very good direct selling environment. And of course, the economic level of Indonesia is not where it will be yet, but it's growing. And so I'm feel very comfortable about the growth of Indonesia going forward.
Mm-hmm. The Asia Pacific contribution is around 46% direct selling.
Yes.
How big is Indonesian contribution?
It's actually only 0.6% of the total contribution.
Okay.
So obviously we can see that the Indonesian opportunity for the future is tremendous.
Yeah.
It's the fourth largest country in the world, and it's still not on the top 10 list of direct sellers. So the growth of Indonesia will be faster than the world on average.
Okay, so you are also the CEO and president of Oriflame Holdings, a multinational company who use the direct selling system and who has been operating in Indonesia since 30 years.
Yeah, more than 30 years, yes.
Okay, how big is Indonesia contribution to Oriflame?
Indonesia is one of the top 5 countries of the Oriflame world, so it's one of the most important countries. It has been growing incredible during the last 20 years. The first 10 years were a struggle. The last 20 years has been fantastic.
Mm-hmm. And another years?
It will be even better.
Okay. So how do you see the future of direct selling in Indonesia, especially the Oriflame?
The impressive thing about Indonesia is it's millennials and the number of young people. In Oriflame, we have a lot of young people.
Mm-hmm.
And they are very, very skilled in social media. Actually, I consider Indonesia to be the number one country in the Oriflame world when it comes to usage of social media as a mean for selling, education, and motivation. Mm-hmm. It is just fantastic to see these young, strong women using social media. They are the future of this country and of Oriflame.
Can we be the engine of growth of direct selling?
Absolutely.
Uh-huh.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay. But I see that you have a production unit in Poland, China, what else?
India.
Russia and India. Will we see one here in Indonesia?
Well, maybe. I think that there's a different fashion about production. And is also, we have about 50% of all our products produced in-house.
Mm-hmm.
And we're happy with that because we don't want to have more because you want competition between your own factories and subcontractors.
Mm-hmm.
But as Indonesia grows, possibly or very likely, they will also have production in Indonesia.
Mm-hmm. Is it in the near future or still very far?
It is not in the near future if we speak about this year or next year. Uh-huh. But beyond that, I would not like to answer.
Okay, so Oriflame's annual selling is more than 1.5 billion euro.
Yes.
Compared to other direct selling companies globally,
yeah.
Where is Oriflame? Is it in the top chart?
We are around top 10. It's I don't remember if it's number 11 or 12 or what, but somewhere around number 10.
Mm-hmm. So do you have target to bring the Oriflame to the top chart?
We want to be number one.
Yeah. What's the strategy?
It's actually being in the countries which we believe in growth. We have now established ourselves in India, Indonesia, mm-hmm. and China. Mm-hmm. These are the countries where we believe growth will come. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, Africa. So we geographically want to be in the countries where most of the growth. But then I also have to be humble. For us, it's not the most important to be number one in absolute terms.
Mm-hmm.
It is more to be number one in our attitude, to be better every day.
Mm-hmm.
Then if you are the best you are every day, then sooner or later you'll be number one.
Very ideal, yeah? That's the ideal. That's,
yes.
That's what you teach to your, what you share to your consultant.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, it's the same as we do with our kids. Try to be the best you are.
Every day.
Every day.
Better, every day. Okay, we will still continue our discussion, but another break. I have to take another break. Pemirsa, kami masih akan melanjutkan perbincangan dengan Magnus Brandstrom sesaat lagi. Tetaplah bersama kami. Terima kasih Anda masih bersama top eksekutif pemirsa dan perbincangan kami akan dilanjutkan kembali. Mr. Brandstrom, in a direct selling, Oriflame involves 3.6 million independent beauty consultants. So that's a lot, you know, how to maintain them and to keep their spirit to sell high?
Well, it is like any other company. We have to provide great products, mm-hmm. we have to provide news. And we have to obviously be relevant all the time. So it's like any other company, we have to come up with new products. We have to sell them at interesting prices and merchandising.
Mm-hmm.
We have to have various competitions. So it's a big machine to keep everyone interested in our company.
But you also pamper your consultant with gifts, awards, or traveling awards. So
of course.
Where's the money from? Is it from the product selling?
Yes, of course it is. So, I mean, when other companies are putting their money into TV advertising, we put a lot less on TV and we put a lot more on our consultants. And part mm-hmm. of their remuneration to consultants are trips and travel abroad, because mm-hmm. it's very inspiring for them to see the world.
Mm-hmm. So does it mean that there are certain percentage of your product back to the consultant?
Absolutely.
The pampering of your
Absolutely.
Consultant?
Absolutely.
Yeah, but instead of advertising in TV, you choose a very famous person and using catalogs.
Yes.
Doesn't it cost you some money too?
Yes, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Our profitability and the retail company's profitability is about the same.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just instead of putting money into TV advertising,
which
is very expensive, we put money into the consultants, to ordinary people's opportunity to fulfill their dreams, to go for a better life.
So you sell dreams?
We sell dreams.
And lots of people buying it?
Well, I think so. I think there is a... people would like... Everyone has a dream.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone would like to be, or very many people would like to be the masters of their own life.
Mm-hmm.
And by working with Oriflame, you actually become more the master of your life. And you're not so dependent on the outside world, and I think that's something that people long for, especially in times like this.
Okay. Yeah, if we are looking for Oriflame's numbers are very awesome. Annual sale more than 1.5 billion euro, 3.6 million independent consultants operate in more than 60 countries. This year or next year, what are your targets?
Well, we are a long-term company, and we say that we want to improve every year. But we have a long-term financial target of improving in local currency in 10% top level revenue
mm-hmm.
and reaching a 15% profitability. And that is a five-year target to over every year to do so.
Mm-hmm.
So we just have the target of improving every year, just to become a little bit better every day.
In Indonesia, there are certain issues of halal label in cosmetics and food. How much you concern about that?
Well, it is something where Indonesian government and the Indonesian people have decided they want to have a different labeling. And we have to be in Indonesia, we love to be in Indonesia, so we have to adapt to that legislation. Mm-hmm. We are absolutely comfortable with our products. They are completely halal, but the certification process is cumbersome. Mm-hmm. But we have to adapt, and it's in the process.
We can trust that, yeah?
Yes, absolutely. Okay.
So it's been 12 years that you are acting as a CEO and the president of Oriflame Holdings. How's cosmetic and beauty product business changing within 12 years?
Well, I think that what we're discussing in terms of the e-commerce, the whole world is changing. It used to be everyone was in a certain box, female beauty, male beauty, yeah, etc. Now it's more mixed, and it was also demographics were different. People in this age only use those type of products, and young people only use those products. Rich people use those products, and poor people use those. Now everything is a mixture, so it's in that sense much more interesting and much more diverse.
Okay, thank you very much for your time, Mr. Magnus Brandstrom.
Thank you very much.
Pemirsa, demikian perbincangan saya dengan Magnus Brandstrom, CEO and President of Oriflame Holdings, sekaligus menjabat sebagai Chairman of World Federation of Direct Selling Association. Kita berjumpa dalam Top Eksekutif pekan depan.
Metro TV, knowledge to elevate.